now from coffee to college. In our latest story, in partnership with The Atlantic magazine, we look at an unusual push by Starbucks to give their employees access to higher education.
It's 6 a.m. and 23-year-old Markel Cullum Herbison is already at the computer, getting in a little studying before she's off to her full-time job.
So proud of her.
I knew that the only way out was to have an education.
The plan had always been that mom and dad would help Markel pay for some of that education.
They lived in a 5-bedroom home, 3 bathrooms, 2-story. It was beautiful.
That all changed overnight in 2008 when the economic crash hit Markel's family brutally.
I remember signing up for food stamps. It was that bad.
Today, Markel is still living at home to help make ends meet. She is one of 21 million people enrolled in U.S. colleges this year. Now, more than ever, the challenge for low-income students and others is not getting into college, but finishing.
American colleges are not really historically designed to make sure students finish. They are designed to enroll students.
Writer and author Amanda Ripley has specialized in higher education.
We have one of the highest college dropout rates in the developed world. We have 35 million people now who have started college and not gotten a degree.
For Markel, a scholarship to community college got her through 2 years, but she had no idea how to afford the 2 more years it would take to earn a degree while working 40-hour weeks at Starbucks. She's one of the first Starbucks employees to benefit from a unique financial aid program started last year by an unusual duo. The man who introduced Americans to the Grande Latte, Starbucks CEO Howard Schultz, and the president of Arizona State University, Michael Crow, announced the expansion of a program that will have the company pay for the college education of its employees. Now, if they work at least 20 hours a week, all 140,000 Starbucks employees are eligible for a 4-year, tuition-free online education at Arizona State University.
The role and responsibility of a for-profit public company can't be just about making money. It has to be about giving back, and it has to be about achieving the balance between profit and social impact.
The very existence of the College Achievement Plan suggests few want to make a career of being a barista. Schultz says he wants employees to get the education that will equip them to move up to higher level jobs at Starbucks.
Adam, I've got your minty skinny vanilla latte.
Our republic is built around the notion that the key to our democracy will ultimately be the education of our people, and the advancement of our democracy will depend upon their education. Well, it's not working now.
The average college grad now leaves school with $30,000 of debt. At 4-year private colleges, it goes as high as $100,000. 40 million Americans have at least one student loan, with most juggling as many as 4.
What I noticed early on is people had a lot of shame about their personal debt. And you have to peel the onion back, and finally, someone has enough courage to say, I'm so embarrassed, but I had $5,000 in debt and I haven't been able to pay it off.
Since the 2008 recession, student debt has jumped 84% to a record $1.3 billion, surpassing even credit card debt in America. The personal consequences of not succeeding to finish or to pay it off can put a student in debt for decades. There's also a hidden emotional cost.
People, I think, their self-esteem was crushed as a result of failing the first time and then being saddled with that debt.
If Schultz and Crow understand the stigma that failure can be for a student, how easy it is to lose hope, it's because it goes back to their own roots.
I think when I sat in a room with these young kids and felt hopelessness from them, it took me back to a different time in my life, living in the projects in Brooklyn, New York. I can remember it as if it was right now, and I still have the scars and the shame of what it meant to be a poor kid.
But the they needed was a warm, welcoming, safe place where they could advance their personal development. So we created that.
Every Starbucks student gets an enrollment counselor, a financial aid advisor, an academic advisor to help pick out classes, and then an ongoing success coach, as they call it, to help them deal with the inevitable problems that come up.
It was a lot of pressure on me, and it was scary to have to make those adult decisions and those grown-up decisions without having all of that life experience.
That's a real challenge. Too many colleges are good at everything, it seems, but customer service.
I think American colleges are confused places. They are trying to enroll students, and they are very good at that. They are trying to garner research funds, and they are good at that. Many are trying to gain status, and they are good at that. But those things often are at odds, actually, with helping students finish efficiently and thrive in the modern economy.
Mario Matus is Markell's personal advisor, and that has been the key to success so far.
There's that fear of I'm falling behind, or this isn't what I expected, or maybe this isn't the right major for me. We want them to know that that's okay, that's part of the process. It's not just you and a computer on an island, you're part of a community.
And it's really nice to have someone there through those hard times and there to celebrate all of your accomplishments.
Having someone in your court like that who texts you and calls you and checks in and is there to give you a little advice or a little support turns out to be hugely important.
Nationally, students who enroll in online courses are more likely to fail or withdraw. Low-performing students or those who have previously struggled in college tend to fall farther behind in online work. This is another reason Starbucks and ASU provide the advisors, although most are unable to meet face-to-face, like Markell, who lives near the ASU campus.
The goal here, though, Howard Schultz, is to move the baristas, the people who work for you, on and up out of the company.
The goal of the company is not move them out of the company. The goal of the company is to give them new tools, new resources, and obviously a broader comprehensive education to do many other things within Starbucks.
Even though tuition comes at a discount, if students don't finish a course, they'll be even deeper in debt. Perhaps that's why sign-ups for the program started slow. In addition, initially only students who already had 2 years of college credit were eligible to participate. Now, any employee working 20 hours a week is eligible.
You wouldn't be doing this if you didn't think it would help your bottom line.
That's exactly right, but I'm doing it because I recognize more than ever that not only do we have to exceed the expectations of our customers, but we have to exceed the expectations of our people to succeed.
This can benefit ASU at a time when universities face decreasing enrollment.
I do think that in this case, their business interests and their social justice interests are aligned.
You know, the American dream is opportunity. That is what we stand for here. We are a culture where anything is possible. We are setting new standards. It truly is the American dream, and we are bringing that back.
Hundreds of other workers like Markell will determine if that dream is achievable online while working part-time.